This video is going to be about solving an equation for a variable. So let's get started. Let's say you're given the equation 3x plus y equals 5, and you're given the instructions, solve for y in terms of x. All that means is you want to get the y by itself on one side of an equation, and everything else is going to go on the other side. So looking at this, 3x plus y equals 5, I want to get the 3x off of the left side of the equation. So what I'm going to do is subtract 3x. I have to subtract that from both sides. This is the same thing I would have done if it just said 3 plus y equals 5. I would have subtracted 3. Now I've got 3x. I'll subtract 3x. So carrying out the subtraction, the 3x and the negative 3x cancel. I've got the y by itself. And on the right side of the equation, I've got 5 minus 3x. Now it's important to realize that this original equation, 3x plus y equals 5, and the one I just came up with, y equals 5 minus 3x, really give the same information. They're both the same equation, just in a different form. Here's another one. So I've got 4x plus 2y equals 7, and once again I'm told to solve this equation for y in terms of x. So I want to get the y by itself. Once again, thinking about this as if the 4x was maybe just a 4. If it was just a 4, I would just subtract 4. So what I'm going to do is subtract 4x. In other words, I take what was added to this side and subtract it. So I'll subtract 4x. The 4x and the negative 4x cancel. I've got 2y. On the right side of the equation, I've got 7 minus 4x. And now I've just got to divide by 2 to get the y by itself. Now when I divide by 2, I have to divide everything by 2. So 2y divided by 2 is just going to give me y. 7 divided by 2, I can't reduce this fraction, so I'm just going to leave it as 7 over 2. 4x divided by 2, well, the 4 can be divided by the 2, so 2 goes into 4 2 times. And I've got y equals 7 halves minus 2x. Here's a couple more. So this is d equals rt. You might recognize this as a formula for figuring out the distance. Distance equals rate times time. And you might have to figure out the rate. In other words, you might want to solve this equation for r in terms of the d and the t. What that means is we want to get the r by itself. Okay, so we've got r multiplied by t. If we want to undo that multiplication, I'll divide by t. I have to divide by t on both sides. These t's will cancel. I'm going to get d over t equals r. And if I want to put that into the format where I've said into a different form, I can just say, oh, that's the same as r equals d over t. In other words, the letter you're solving for, the variable you're solving for, very often in your final form is going to go on the left side of the equation. Both these are really the same thing. This is the area of a triangle. So the area equals the base times the height divided by 2, or a equals bh over 2. And let's say we're told to solve for b. So we want to get the b by itself. Well, the first thing I think I want to do is get rid of this fraction. So I'm going to multiply both sides by 2. That means I'll have 2a equals, I'm sorry, I didn't write the multiplication. 2a equals bh, and I wanted to solve for b, so I'll divide both sides by h. These h's will cancel. I'll have 2a over h equals b, and I can just swap the sides and write that as b equals 2a over h. And that's all there is to it. So just remember, when you're told to solve for a variable, the variable, when they say solve for x or solve for y, the thing you're solving for is the variable you want to isolate. Everything else you're going to put on the other side of the equation and then simplify it wherever possible. So that's it for now. Take care. I'll see you next time.